My parents are really fantastic, and you know, my mom was born here, and she's very open-minded and liberal. I mean, I'm Italian, and my dad came here and immigrated here from a really small poor town when he was 20. And what I realized with my dad is that, you know, he wasn't intolerant, he just didn't know.
Yeah.
He just had no clue. He had never met a gay person before.
Right.
So I started to realize the difference between hate and not understanding. And sometimes we confuse those. So what I do is I try to encourage kids to approach the straight community not with this defensive attitude, but with a little bit of a benefit of the doubt. And so for me, when I came out, I realized it was actually quite selfless, because now, as an open out person, I became an ambassador and an educator. I was kind of like an expert in my field,
right,
that a lot of people didn't know about. And suddenly I had to find a way to let my dad understand. And going through that process and seeing his journey alongside mine, and seeing now that, I mean, he is like my ultimate supporter and my number one fan and like pretty much my best friend.
Does that surprise you?
You know what? In retrospect, it does. In the moment,
right,
I didn't think about it. I was like, I know my dad can do this. I was very hopeful. But in retrospect, to see the journey that he went through, it does surprise me. I mean, we have cultural gaps, you know?
Yeah.
There's these, especially being Canadian, we have like these cultural gaps. We also have generational gaps.
Yes,
and you put
do.
Those together, culture and a different culture in a different generation, suddenly that gap seems quite big. And that's why I say, you know, as out people, as gay, you know, lesbians, transgender, people that are out and are open and have the confidence to speak, it's our kind of responsibility, it's our mission to educate. We got to shrink that gap.
Yeah.
And with my father, I realized it can be shrunk. It really can, and it has, and it's small. And now there's still a bit of a gap.
Mm-hmm.
There's still empty spaces where, you know, there's a little bit of a disconnect, and sometimes I can see him get nervous or not understand. I just got to help him through. But that gap did shrink, and that's, like, it's time that we acknowledge this gap and we start to find ways to shrink it. And I think that it starts with pretty much the first thing, which seems like a common sense notion, but we need to start telling young people, we seem to tell kids that gays exist.
Yeah.
And that's something that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
And you think, we have all these like kind of heterosexual common knowledge, common sense ideas of like, you know, like we're saying, like, I mean, straight kind of heterosexual unions and families, which especially if we're saying Italian, you know, it's family is very, like our lives are very much based in family. So these common sense straight notions are not questioned. And I think young people, I think educators and community leaders need to start to educate young people that gays do exist, that these are groups that you're gonna encounter in your life. These are minority groups that go through different challenges, and that we as a responsible community have to accept the extra pressures and also help them through.